Hey guys, welcome to my 3D modeling tutorial. In this video, I'll show you step by step how to create a chocolate bar wrapper in Blender. Let's get started. The first thing you do is delete the default light and camera, then bring in your reference image using Shift A. You can find a link to the image in the description box below. Rotate using RY90, then click on the Properties tab and reduce the opacity. You can shift the image back a bit towards the Y direction. Now we can begin. Add a new cube using Shift A, switch to X-ray mode using Alt Z, then switch to Edit mode using Tab, and scale down using S. You can adjust the reference image location to match the cube. Next, scale the cube in the Y direction to make it thinner. Then add a loop cut here in the middle. Switch to X-ray mode, select the two vertices at the bottom, and then X to delete it. We can see that it creates an opening at the bottom part. This will help us to use the mirror modifier to complete the lower part. Add the mirror modifier, change the axis from X to Z, and we can see that it reflected the box towards the Z direction. Switch back to edit mode, and in X-ray mode, select the two vertices at the top and move up towards the Z direction. And as you can see, the lower part moves down as well. So whatever we do on the upper part will be replicated on the lower part. Extrude again towards the Z direction, then scale in towards the Y direction to get that thin part at the top. Switch to front view mode and then scale the top part towards the X direction. Extrude again towards the Z direction, but let it stop underneath the zigzag at the top. And we can see it's already taking the basic shape of the chocolate wrapper. I reduced the body size a bit here because I was thinking it was looking too big. The next thing we'll do is create this zigzag part at the top. To do that, we'll add some loop cuts to the body of the wrapper. I added 41 to mine. Switch to top view, and then select all the edges at the top. Go to the select option, and then select checker deselect. This will select every other edge. Move the selected edges up according to the reference image. And we can see it's looking good. You can add in the subdivision modifier to check how it looks. We can see that it deforms the shape. To rectify that, we'll have to add some loop cuts. Let's turn up the subdivision modifier first to see what we are doing. Press Ctrl R here to add a loop cut, then drag it up. This will make the top more defined. Press Ctrl R again, and then press E to make it straight, and then drag it down. Add another loop cut here as well and drag it up. And you can switch the subdivision modifier on again to check. Drag the edge up a little bit more, but this is according to personal preference. Increase the level viewport to 2 and then shade smooth. And we can see that it looks really good. If you are getting value from this tutorial, kindly give this video a like and subscribe to my channel. This will encourage me a lot to put out more content like this. Thank you. You can see that the top of our model looks rounded compared to the top on the reference image. The top on the reference image looks sharper. You don't have to make it sharper, it just depends on what you want. To make it sharper, we'll have to use the knife tool to manually add in more edges. To do that, we'll first add in a loop cut by pressing Ctrl R and then press E to straighten it and then drag it up a bit. Press K to select the knife tool and then click here, then press C. This C will make sure it cuts through the back as well, and then cut through it like this. Press K again, click, press C, and then cut through. Then do the same for the other side as well. You can check the other side to see if there are no any issues. And as we can see, it's got the back perfectly well. Now you can go ahead and do the rest. We can see now that the top part now looks sharper. Now it remains the bottom part. To do this, you press K and then click and then press C and then cut through the rest part. You can check how it looks now, and you can see that it looks sharp with no distortions. Then you can go ahead and do the rest. And we can see now that the top part is now pretty sharp, just like the reference image. Next, you can add up the lines at the top as well. To do that, press Ctrl R and add 4 loop cuts. Then press Ctrl B to bevel them just once. And then press Alt C and then select Extrude Faces along normals. And then we have this. You can also have little dents on the wrapper if you want. This will make it look more realistic. To do this, you can apply the mirror modifier first, then switch to edit mode and add 5 loop cuts on the top and the bottom part. Select like 4 edges like this, then turn on proportional editing, and then scroll it down a bit. Then moving a bit towards the Y direction, just a little bit. This will create a bit of dent on the wrapper. You can keep adding more dents according to your taste. And we have our chocolate bar wrapper completed. Thank you so much for sticking with me till the end. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a like and subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you in the next tutorial.